A people that lived in darkness has seen a great light. On those who dwell in the land and shadow of death, a light has dawned. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus and his followers went as far as Capernaum, and as soon as the Sabbath came, Jesus went to the synagogue and began to teach. And his teaching made a deep impression on them, because unlike the scribes, he taught them with authority. In their synagogue just then there was a man possessed by an unclean spirit, and he shouted, "What do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." But Jesus said sharply, "Be quiet, come out of him." And the unclean spirit threw the man into convulsions, and with a loud cry went out of him. The people were so astonished that they started asking each other what it all meant. "Here is a teaching that is new," they said, "and with authority behind it. He gives orders even to unclean spirits and they obey him. And his reputation rapidly spread everywhere through all the surrounding Galilean countryside." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, this sermon wants to follow the main thought and motto of Congress taking place today and tomorrow, organized by Medjugorje in Deutschland Center. 40 years of mercy and grace, 40 years that Our Lady is with us. We are approaching 40th anniversary of Our Lady's apparitions in the parish of Medjugorje. 40 is a biblical number, was mentioned in different places. Flood lasted for 40 days and nights. Moses spent 40 days on Sinai and nights. Israelites walked through desert for 40 years. Elijah for 40 days and night walked to holy mountain Horeb. The inhabitants of Nineveh for 40 days did a penance. Jesus fasted in the desert for 40 days. 40 days after his ascension, after his resurrection, Jesus ascended into heaven. For 40 years, heaven has been opening in through Medjugorje to this earth, a Blessed Mother Gospa coming to us and speaking to her children. We are entering the 40th anniversary of Our Lady's apparitions in time which is similar to a desert. Namely, our time is in which we live is marked by pandemic coronavirus that brought many troubles and confusion throughout the world. We may say that there is total devastation on many life in many life areas, not just economy, tourism, air and road transportation, etc., but even relations among people have been disturbed. Being afraid of being near somebody else and thus catching up contagious disease makes people become distant to each other. That is a trouble that causes anxiety, crisis of faith and hope. Many people no longer feel that security as before, since the foundation on which you built your daily life is gone. the spirit of desert is spread. But the desert we are going through does not only bring us difficulties, but at the same time represents challenge and chance. One of the most important questions that we should ask in this time is about foundation on which we have been building our lives. If so far we based our foundation in what is earthly, material, worldly, the desert we are going through on the one side is opening our eyes that all that is fragile and weak, and on the other side it is bringing to our attention that God is the only one who is constant, who does not fade away, and that we should only in Him look for our foundation. Trials may teach us a lot, to live in a more modest and simple way, not to invest far too much in things that are transitory, to work all the harder on true values, faith, hope and love, our own family and true friends. Time in which we live is calling us to become aware of the desert within ourselves and around us. Desert is within us. If our heart is so filled with wrong things that we no longer have time for the Word of God, we are no longer capable to take time to sit in our house, hold Holy Scripture in hands open and read it. We don't have time to look into the eyes of our spouse, our child, and listen to them. Heart has become dumb and is no longer rejoicing over little simple things. It is too slow to understand the one who is in need and trouble. Desert is in us if heart has become dumbed, too dumb to notice the beauty of God's creatures, sky full of stars, and the beauty of a flower. We need a desert. We need silence in order to become aware of noise within us and around us. Saint Hildegard von Bingen said, "Heavenly music exists in everything, but we have forgotten how to listen and hear it, to it and hear it, because we are overpowered by our own voice." It is not easy to hear because we are so used to noise that we are disturbed when it is quiet. Only when we go to desert, we become aware of need to hear and we become capable of hearing. We need desert in order to be able to listen to the Word of God. Therefore, through the prophet Hosea, God invites, "I will take you to the desert and I will speak there to your heart." Jewish saying says, "True taste of water we recognize only in desert." Only in desert do we become aware of how precious is every single drop of water, fresh, clean air that we breathe, and beautiful landscapes in which we live or we are passing through. We need the deserted region in order to be able to see. Only in desert do we notice again the lily, the little ant, bird, and we recognize their beauty and how special each one is. Desert through which we are currently going is a chance for us to discover again the presence of Blessed Mother among us and to answer to her calls. The 40th anniversary of Our Lady having chosen the parish of Medjugorje is a call to all of us to remember and examine ourselves. The reason I say that we should recall memories, because we must not forget. Moses and other prophets constantly had to remind Israelites that they are chosen people and graces that they received. I quote, "Remember, you too were slaves in the land of Egypt, and Yahweh set you free from there, your God, with his hand strong and extended." This is why Yahweh, your God, commanded you to observe and respect Saturday. The same call to remember is what parishioners of Medjugorje need, as well as all others who have heard Our Lady's call and already answered it. It has been 40 years since Our Lady has chosen us, 40 years that Mother accompanies and guides her people through the deserts of our time, from different forms of slavery toward freedom, from different forms of restlessness toward peace. Being chosen means that Our Lady's hand is extended toward us. In these 40 years, so many parishioners and so many people from around the world have answered Our Lady's call and with heart accepted her hand. Apart from being called to examine ourselves after 40 years, anniversary is also a chance for a new beginning. New beginning is a new chance to live that what the Queen of Peace has been already calling us to previously. Dear children, I am with you and I am inviting you with seriousness to start to pray and fast like the early days of my coming. 40 years that Mother of God has been with us, it is a chance for to give our answer in collaboration with unspeakable God's grace as during early first days of her comings to us. Let us pray to the Holy Spirit in order to be able in the time of pandemic, spiritual desert, to answer to Mother's calls. Because being chosen still goes on. Amen.
Ispovjedimo vjeru.